हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मी सौरभ अवस्थी, इंग्लिश फैकल्टी ऑफ माउंट लिट्राजी स्कूल झांसी, वेयर टुडे आई हैव ब्रॉट अ न्यू पोयम ऑफ क्लास 9, दैट इज द स्नेक ट्राइंग विच हैज़ बीन रिटन बाय WWE रॉस। सो स्टूडेंट्स, हेयर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द स्नेक which is trying to save itself from a stick which is following it. So this is a poem, The Snake Trying, which has been written by WWE Ross, which is a very easy to understand poem, where we will start with the introduction of this poem, then followed by the summary of the poem. So let's begin now. This small poem is the poet's plea to human beings to treat snakes in a kind manner. As well as, here poets also wants to say that humans generally tend to kill snakes to avoid being bitten. But the poet reveals that all snakes are not poisonous, and all of them do not harm humans. Now let's continue with the summary. In this poem, a harmless green colored snake tries to save itself from being hit by a person who is chasing it with a stick to kill it. The poet says that the snake is harmless even to children. People fear snakes, and when they see one, they try to kill it with a stick. The snake tries to save itself and hides behind the green colored bushes of marshy plants growing in the water. It hides in the ripples of the water body in order to save itself. The snake disappears behind the marshy plants. So this is the summary. Now we will continue with the stanza wise explanation. So let's begin the first stanza. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. So here, pursuing means chasing or following, and curvings means twisting. So the meaning of the stanza is, the snake tries to escape from being hit by the stick that is following it. As the snake crawls, its body twists and turns, forming fascinating shapes. So here, students, this paragraph is telling us about that when that snake is trying to escape from that place by that stick, at that time the shape which was formed was looking very beautiful and fascinated. So finally here it is discussed about the beauty of the snake. Okay, now coming to the next stanza. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. Small and green, he is harmless even to children. So here, students, reeds means first of all water or marsh plants. So here, now, the poet wants to say something with the help of this poem, that is, the snake moves through the water in order to save itself. The poet pleads to let it escape and hide behind the thick marshy plants as it is harmless. The small green colored snake is harmless even to children. Poet wants to say to that man, the one who is holding that stick, that please don't hit him. he is not having any poison. That is a very, that means harmless snake, even for the children's. So don't hit him. Okay, this was second stanza. Now coming to the third one. Along the sand he lay until observed and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So first of all, the meaning of the words vanishes, it means disappears, and ripple means a small wave on the surface of water. And now explanation is, till it was spotted and chased away by the person holding a stick, it lay quietly in the sand. In order to save itself, the snake disappears in the ripples of the water and hides in the camouflaging green bushes of the marshy plants. So, students, now here you must have understood that here how the snake, which is a beautiful creature created by God, is lying somewhere and hiding itself and enjoying the weather. But a man who is thinking that a snake is poisonous and can kill him, just because of that he is having a stick in his hand and trying to chase him and trying to kill him. So, but here poet is trying to tell to that man with the stick that don't do that. Why? Because he is not so harmful. It cannot harm even the children. So that's why he wants to say that all the snakes are not so poisonous, are not so harmful. So we are no one to kill these beautiful creatures which are present over here in our nature. Okay, so we all have to take care. That means we have to be conscious about them, because they are also having an equal right to live on this earth. Okay, so now this was the summary of the poem. Now we will move on with the important questions which I have brought for you, so that you can understand few questions from the stanza which are given over here in the poem. So let's begin with the questions of first stanza. How does the snake escape the stick? So students, the first answer is, he escaped by sudden curvings in the body. Next question, how does the snake looks when he escaped? So here students, your answer should be that he looks beautiful and graceful. So now these were two questions which I have taken from first stanza. There can be more questions, but right now I have given only two questions from each stanza right now for you, so that you can just practice and you can try to understand that how the questions used to come from these stanzas. Okay, now coming to the second stanza now. The first question is, who is him in the first line? So here, him is the snake. So that means here, students, you can say like this also, that a figure of speech, that means a poetic device has been used over here, that is where a snake is compared right now with a human being. That means him is used for that snake. Okay, so your answer is, him is the snake right now. Now the next question is, where being the snake be without being hurt? So now the answer is as following, he will be so in the reeds. And what is the meaning of reeds, students? Reeds means long plant like bamboo, where he is going to hide himself. So this was your second stanza. Now the last one, and after then we will conclude this explanation, this poem, this video. Okay, so now the question is, the last question: what does the snake do in the ripples? So here, student, first of all you should know the meaning of ripples, which mean waves. And one more word is here for you, that means vanishes, which means to get disappeared. Okay, to vanish away from some place, that means to get disappeared from there. Okay, and now again I am coming to the last question, that is, what does the snake do in the ripples? So answer is, the snake vanishes in the ripples. So now, students, I hope that this video will be beneficial for you, and it will help you in understanding this poem of class 9th, that is the snake trying. Okay, now I am concluding this video. So stay healthy, stay safe, and stay at home. Thank you so much.